Hi, everybody. Good Sunday afternoon. Meteorologist Griffin Hardy here with an update on your forecast. Thanks for logging on what is a very, very messy day on top of the messy day that we saw yesterday. Rain still coming down in Greenville right now. Still looking at scattered showers across much of the upstate. We saw some heavier downpours at times, and parts of the area have gotten a really good soaking. Oconee County and Pickens County, we've seen as much as 2 inches of rain just in the past 24 hours. And as expected, we may already be seeing some of that rain transition into sleet or snow showers up on the Tennessee-North Carolina border along that northern Swain County line with the border with Tennessee up towards Bryson City and Cherokee may already starting to get some wintry weather as expected. Meanwhile, farther south across Anderson County and parts of Abbeville County, some heavier downpours between Anderson and Donalds right now. Farther over towards the east, you've got some lighter showers across Lawrence County towards Waterloo and Greenwood, seeing some light rain there on radar as well. Back towards the north and western North Carolina, again, just light rain for the moment down towards the valleys in Buncombe County and Henderson counties, but back towards the west again, also seeing some light rain. It's really where that colder air is just starting to come in, where we may start to get some of that transition into wintry weather. And that'll be the story later on tonight around 8-9 o'clock, when most of western North Carolina could be seeing snow showers. Rain totals pretty impressive again across Oconee County and northern Pickens County. All the shades of yellow there, that's upwards of 2 inches that we're seeing there in total just the past 24 hours. Notice the gaps in the data here. That's just because the radar is a bit blocked by the mountains here. So we are seeing some pretty impressive amounts reported by rain gauges across Henderson County and Transylvania County, where as much as 3-4 inches of rain has fallen, which is great news because we definitely need the rain as the drought continues. We've got some severe weather ongoing across eastern North Carolina and southern Virginia. This is where the winds are out of the south, and you know the timing of the system works out better during the warmest part of the day. Right about now, 3-4 o'clock is normally when you start to get those better severe weather ingredients, and luckily we missed those. The worst of the dynamics of this system passed through early this morning, so any chance of severe weather we had is pretty much on the back burner for now as the front comes in. Check out the difference in temperatures. 40s right now across Nashville and Knoxville, 60s and 70s on the eastern side of that front, where you got really strong south winds and thus a decent chance for some severe weather like they're seeing up towards Raleigh. Those wind gusts on the backside of that front, man, they're going to get strong tonight, especially across western North Carolina. All these shades of purple here across the northern half of the upstate and much of western North Carolina, those gusts could be as high as 40 miles per hour this evening. Hold on to your hats and move inside anything you can, because it is definitely going to be a very blustery night as temperatures really go into free fall mode. We're going to get down close to freezing again by early tomorrow morning, and luckily by tomorrow afternoon, well, it's still going to be breezy. It won't be nearly as bad as what we'll see wind wise later tonight, with gusts only around 15 miles per hour tomorrow afternoon. Again, the rain continues for a few more hours, and that gradual transition into sleet and snow happens across the majority of western North Carolina, maybe across the very far northern fringe of the upstate, the northwestern part of Oconee County. You may get lucky to see some flurries, but the vast majority of us south of the north-south Carolina border, probably not going to see snow tonight. The temperature is just a little bit too warm. It'll be right on the border with the snow temperature wise towards Asheville and Hendersonville, so be on the lookout for that. But the rest of us farther south, you're out of luck, and it'll be a pretty fast paced burst of snow that we're going to see. It's going to be heavy, wet snow that we'll see across Asheville and Hendersonville, but it'll be over with by the time we get to midnight. Then we're right back to being cold and dry again tomorrow morning, upper 20s to mid 30s when you wake up early tomorrow, and sunshine with us the rest of the day tomorrow. But it's going to stay cold all day with temperatures still in the 40s by lunchtime. And by the time we get to mid-afternoon, at best, we're going to be in the low and mid-50s in the upstate, while the mountains stay pretty much in the 40s all day long into tomorrow. Dry for the rest of next week, it looks like. For Monday through Friday, we've got mainly dry conditions ahead. That snow potential looks to have backpedaled somewhat for down in the valleys, but up to the northeast of Asheville, still the best looking snow total so far, around 1 to 2 inches there. But again, it'll be a very fast paced burst of snow, enough to get some pictures, but not much accumulation expected. Now here's the upper air pattern. That upper level low is what's giving us all this active weather we've seen this weekend. What's going to happen over the course of the next week is that the colder, drier air will continue filtering in. But by Thursday, we're going to be watching for this cutoff low to be developing. What that is a low that breaks off the jet stream and can really throw a wrench in your forecast. These things can can often be pretty erratic. The forecast models can usually have a hard time handling them. So into next weekend, the forecast does look a little bit uncertain, I'll say. It does look like I had yesterday the chance for rain Saturday, and now looks like Sunday might be the best possible day that we get that next chance for rain. So good news there, but we'll keep our eyes on it. Just want to throw that out there. The cutoff lows can definitely make forecasts a little bit more tricky, so we'll make some adjustments as the week goes on. But in the meantime, cold and dry once we get past tonight. Here's a look at your 4-day. Sunny, cold, and windy for tomorrow. In the upstate, sunny with thin clouds Tuesday. It's going to be very consistent weather-wise, just cold, dry, and mostly sunny for Monday through Friday, with highs staying in the 50s and lows close to freezing pretty much every day for the upcoming week. And by the time we get to next weekend, again, we're going to be watching for that cutoff low to develop. I'm going with just a 10% chance for Saturday and a 30% chance for Sunday. We'll make some adjustments as the week goes on. 40 plus for the mountains looks like this. Sunnier, very cold and windy tomorrow once that quick burst of snow showers comes in tonight. It'll be in and out before you know it. Sunny with thin high clouds for Tuesday. Again, staying mostly sunny for a majority of this week with highs in the 50s and lows mainly in the 20s. Very cold week ahead for sure. And then Saturday, Sunday, also looking at a possible chance for rain by the time you get to next Sunday with that cutoff low. Have a great rest of your Sunday night, everybody.